Good afternoon, everyone. Hope I am audible. So today I want to discuss our AI POC that we did for job agency. So there are we'll discuss what is the business use case, data overview, the architecture that we have for our solution, what is the model methodology that we have used. So for the POC that I'll be showcasing here, so it is pretty simple classifiers that we have built. And finally, how we are doing our model management and deployment. So that is part of our orchestration strategy. So there are many recruitment processes, like when a company is hiring, they will look at your resume, or like these days, you can get hired on social media. But there are also many recruitment agencies where the corporates or any kind of business organizations, they post their job requirements. So they recruit for either regular jobs for engineers, developers, or sometimes blue collar jobs for maintenance workers, or it could be carpenter or anything. So the use case that we have is the job agent who receives all these numerous job requests, which are varied in nature, from various organizations, then manually catalogs them for further deliberations with team members. So it's not like he gets the pick like in a random fashion, that he can pick up any use case, job request to work on. So they have to work with their teams and finalize, okay, so today I'm going to work on these top 10 job requests that we have selected, in hopes that it will be giving more revenue compared to others. So that revenue metric depends upon how a job request is bringing in value, or how complex it is. So our solution, we intend to automate the complexity score of these job orders. And of course, it can be linked to the value of that job order, so that the agent can decide, okay, so this is, let's say it's a low complexity job order, and he wants to, but has a relatively high value. So that should be taken up first rather than others. So that is the basic solution. And the benefits are intuitive with that, like it saves a lot of time. It also takes off what you can say, like human labor out of it. So where earlier they were deliberating in teams, so that kind of can be taken away. And also, like a near real-time request system, we can develop with that. So to completely faster lead time. So in our data overview, I just want to show like what are the sources of data, or what kind of data that we have. So first is like recruitment activities, like how many interviews have been scheduled, or how many submittals have been made, or what is the time taken between interviews and job request submissions, and like number of job openings remaining. Like you can see on that orange column, like so many are there. The other aspect is job request, like whether the applicant has been offered the job, or he has been rejected, or the applicant has rejected the job. So those are the those attributes. Of course, one of the important is customer relationship. So if the agent who is looking at the job request, does he have an existing relationship with the organization prior to that? So our platform right now is based on Azure. So we are completely using all the Azure components, which you can see. So the data can reside from client side anywhere, either in a SAP system or in some their own kind of database. From there, we have to build a pipeline and get it to our blob storage or a SQL DB. So blob storage is nothing but a kind of a data store. You can imagine it like that for those who don't know. So once we have the data store, data in our data store available, that will go to our Azure ML workspace. So that is where we are actually building our all the models and storing them for references. And we'll train the model, package it, and once we are sure that it, or we believe that it is giving satisfactory results, we can then start our deployment strategy. So for staging, we are using right now container instances. For production loads, we are going for Azure Kubernetes Service. So the intent is to get a containerized deployment, so it can be leveraged by any client architecture that they have. They tend to get very nitpicky of how they want to use. And also the advantage that we want to leverage here is, so once we have deployed the model, now we want to see how it is being interacted daily purpose. Like we want to collect the data that is coming in. We want to monitor it. We want to monitor for data drifts so that we can improve if required. So that loop is there from application insights, again going back to storage unit. And if you can observe, then the training and deployment we have automated using DevOps. So like a CI/CD pipeline. So that snapshot also I will able to show you. So for this POC, when it started, it was actually my first POC. So when I started working on, we did a simple model like normal classifiers, and we started with the normal sampling process, pretty standard. Most of you must be knowing SMOT analysis, and because there were very less positive instances that were there, less than 15%, and it was pretty standard, so we went with that. Now we started with our base model with a logistic regression. So it was giving little over 60%, and then we later on improved with other modeling strategies. Currently, the one with which we ended the POC was a random forest model with hyperparameter tuning. So we are also right now for the actual production system that we are trying to build. So for that, we'll be going. We have a deep neural network in mind. Because during the POC stage, we observed that the simple feed-forward network with Keras implementation was giving a pretty good metrics. So you can see the snapshot there. So accuracy, F1 score, and all that. So, so for the POC, we kept it simple. We just went with random forest. So this is just a model brief. Most of you must be knowing that. So now, when we try to interpret our model to our client or to our stakeholders, so they wanted to know what are the variables that are impacting. So they always want to know whether the model is able to understand whether it has really learned on the historical data and or not. So these are some of the findings that I can show you. There were some detailed findings that I have to exclude right now. So anyway, so you can see some basic ones like time taken for job request from request stage to actual interview stage. So the lesser the time, the more the chance is there for the job request getting closed. And the relationship between hiring person and job agent, the number of interviews scheduled. So type of organization or industries also affects that. So what organization and what industry, so that I have excluded right now. The thing is the offshoot here is also we can build a system which classifies that a job request is a valid job request or not. So that is another entire area that we want to focus on in future. So for orchestration, like I said, so we are using Azure ML Workspace. So there we have all our experiments, which engulfs all our ML iterations and model metrics, model versioning, and all that. So this is like a snapshot that one of the workspace that we have and how it is getting logged in. Now, the reason we are going with the AKS deployment is for the standard ones that you can see, like faster response time, auto scaling, hardware escalation and monitoring. primarily monitoring and faster response time and also auto scaling, because the data that the that our unit our clients are having, so it is either on Azure or AWS. So so that kind of cloud architecture they are expecting to for us to handle. So this is the snapshot of our application insights, so where we can collect the data for further analysis of data drift, and this will be it comes in JSON format, and then it will it has to be pipelined to a normal SQL table or a blob storage. So this is the CI/CD setup that we have right now. So as you all will be knowing, so the CI pipeline will be giving an output of a trained model that will be taken up by the staging pipeline. It will be deployed in a staging layer, like in an ACI deployment. And for the further approvals, if they are secured, then we can make an AKS deployment, which is our final production deployment. So that is the entire system overview that we covered. So, so the scope for improvement, there are lots of it in this POC, which we are trying to implement now that we are actually developing it. So one of the key thing is that the data that initially that we got, so it was like a lot of junk data from some obscure dev system that we finally got it. And on that, we are trying to build that. Also, we can we may want to use some kind of social media data. Let's say if we have prior information of how many hirings an organization makes in a particular quarter. So if we can include or incorporate that kind of info, so that might improve our learning. And finally, we are developing a dashboard like this. So that right now is our intended output, like a value indicator. So it will be showing what are low complexity job requests, which are giving higher value. Or if an agent still prefers to go for a high complexity job request, but maybe they are getting a higher value or for any other reason, so they can still go for that. So like a dashboard where they can work with all that. So that we want to provide. So for a like a small set of self-service analytics that we want to enable at that level. So that is pretty much all that I wanted to discuss. Basically, like over a year ago, since I shifted in data science, so back when I was learning in 2018, so that time I imagined like how it will be like. I thought it will be exactly like how it is in Kaggle, so where we get a neat data set, everything is marked and labeled, and there are X variables and there is Y, and somehow I will get that data, and we'll make a pretty good, you know, AI model, and surprise our client with some cool analytics, and you know, be hero, like as if they are the experts, and they don't have they have never observed any kind of abnormality in their systems themselves. But it didn't turn out that way. So this was my first POC, and I'm thankful for MLDS to give me an opportunity to share this. So basically, the reason I wanted to primarily share this is what I have observed in the past 1 year working in TCS is that right now, like our unit is totally in cloud. So the objective is not to showcase what Azure ML can do or how it is doing. So yesterday's keynote was, we started with AWS, I guess. So there also the speaker showcased the capabilities of AWS SageMaker. So the idea is to choose the right set of tools that will be compatible to your system, and you have to convince your client that it is actually adding value. So they will not be interested in what accuracy we are getting or whether the model is simple or complex, or if it is a CNN or whatever it is. So they'll be interested if it actually helps them increasing their revenue. And that is the first aspect, obviously. And the second one is how easy it is to be consumed. So they don't want to, as today's speaker, Mr. Shailesh, he was stressing on the importance of solution. So they don't want to understand like a simple model that they don't want to work in a silo kind of a situation. They want to look at the entire solution from which they can consume it and integrate in their existing systems. So less change is required, and it is more of a kind of an add-on that they want to give. So that is enough from my side.